What did the futurist philosopher Nikolai Fedorov prophesy about Russia and the world? Many predictions and prophecies have been made about Russia. Among them are some very old ones. Monk Vladimir, a resident of Tambov province in the 11th century, uttered the following prophetic words about 1,000 years ago, right? For 1,000 years, the forces of hell, with furious fury raging, will tirelessly attack and shake Russia to its foundations. And the more terrible the pressure, the more faith unites people, and nothing will block the way to the Almighty. The powers of pure light, of otherworldly fire, will overthrow the enemies. Living lights will heal the wounds of a happy country. On the ruins of the old, a great people, rich in the beauty of spirit, will be reborn. Of course, this is prophecies of a Russian monk. And now 1,000 years are ending. Russia went through many trials during this period and is still destined to go through many difficulties. But absolutely all prophecies about our country, they say, that is Russia here, claim that Russia will be the savior of mankind. The Russian cosmologist, philosopher, and futurist Nikolai Fedorov also spoke about this. Fedorov's first prophecy, of course, we have to keep in mind that all these are prophecies made by Russians. In 1829, in the same Tambov province, a boy was born, the illegitimate son of Prince Pavel Gagarin. The child was named Nikolai. According to the customs of that time, the surname and patronymic were written according to the godfather. From childhood, Nikolai Fedorov had an inquiring mind, knew the Holy Bible very well, and more than once discussed the instructions of Christ and the bodily resurrection. At the age of 22, he wrote The Philosophy of Common Cause, in which he outlined his views on immortality and man's role in the universe. Man learns and improves nature. Space, time, and death will win, but by his own work, he will bring about the kingdom of God, and not only on earth, but in the entire universe. They objected to Fedorov. Only God himself could do this, but man is made in the image and likeness of the Creator. He himself is the Creator because a piece of God is embedded in him. Man's mission on earth is, together with the Almighty and with his help, to improve the world, explore the universe, create and create. Many predictions and prophecies have been made about Russia, among them the very old ones. Nikolai Fedorov considered himself a true Christian. The modern trend of occultism or religious movements coming from outside were foreign to him. Every nation has its own faith, and one should not succumb to the temptation, being a Christian, to study, for example, Eastern religions. He means Buddhism and Hinduism, of course. However, according to Fedorov, the Russian people are the most religious, unspoiled by atheism, and it is Russia that should be the first to implement his ideas, he claims. But it happened a little more than 100 years after the publication of The Philosophy of Common Cause. A man flew into space. He was born in Russia and bore the ancient glorious name Gagarin. That was Nikolai's surname, although he was not a prince. But he was able to conquer space. One of the predictions of Nikolai Fedorov was, who was still called in the family by his family's name Gagarin, came true. We had not yet succeeded in defeating time and death, but science has already taken the first steps in this direction. Someday a person will be able to unravel these mysteries. Fedorov's second prophecy. Fedorov believed that every person can be a creator because he has a soul, but there are people who are spiritually wingless and have very low spiritual development. They only want to consume and live for their own pleasure. These are the ones who only use the world, consumers who take everything from life but don't think they need to give anything in return. The astute philosopher had already realized then that scientific and technological progress would lead humanity to degradation. The conveniences and benefits of civilization will increase the number of consumers. This means that people will lose their spirituality and stop developing and creating. Many predictions and prophecies made about Russia, and in order to obtain a new manufactured gain, quote-unquote, Mankind will destroy nature, recklessly waste the Earth's resources, and fight among themselves. One day this will lead to the apocalypse. And this, or the prophecy made in the middle of the 19th century, began to be fulfilled. Look around you. Are there many creators and makers among us? A drop in the bucket compared to consumers. No one even thinks about spiritual growth anymore. From childhood, a person only demands, give me, give me, and not everything is enough for him. We all want to get the best out of life, but well, we are only interested in our material well-being. Natural resources have long been divided by the global elite. Because of them, wars are fought in the world, and more signs are appearing, warning that the last judgment is near. Fortunately, there are countries where this most spiritual and most religious country in the world, they say, he said, is Russia. Our people, he said, are not even spoiled by decades of atheism instilled by the Bolsheviks. We have kept faith in deep faith in the Lord in our subconscious. I'm sorry to say that I don't agree with what he's saying, because, you know, the amount of, for example, abortions that are taking place in Russia is unbelievable. So if a people is that spiritual and religious, how could that be going on? Now, the time, he said, will come, it's already come, when the world will have to tighten its belt, because there cannot be universal prosperity. Absolutely everyone cannot achieve a high material level, and we should look for the meaning of life in something else, in the spiritual. Therefore, Russia is very necessary for God, and history needs it. By the way, this is exactly what a man who had never been to Russia but understood its importance historical role said. After all, it's no coincidence that it is believed that the prophets do not say what they want, but only repeat what is dictated from above. And the fact that the American Edgar Cayce was a real seer has been repeatedly recorded and documented. In the early 30s of the last century, Edgar Cayce said, quote, "Changes are coming. Be sure there will be an evolution or revolution in the ideas of religious thought. The basis of this for the whole world will ultimately come from Russia. It will not be communism, but that what Christ taught, this kind of communism," end quote. Many predictions and prophecies made, and those words were spoken during the most difficult period of Russia's existence, when churches and monasteries were destroyed or turned into warehouses, clubs and colonies of criminals, priests were shot or sent to camps, the gulags, sanctuaries were desecrated and destroyed. Edward Cayce perceived the paradoxical logic of the Russian people's attitude towards religion. The stronger and more persistent the effort to break faith, the deeper it takes root in our souls. Here we can talk about the benefits of prophecy as a means of self-knowledge. We begin to remember who we are, where we come from, and wonder where we're going. People do not understand that the future does not belong to those people who live richer, but those who can find something qualitatively new, which they can create. And to do that, you need to remember your real purpose to create. And this I've translated from a Greek article. Please leave your comments. Thank you for your support. Kindly support my Patreon account. The daily posts are 5 videos daily, and they are totally different from what I have on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for your support and that you find all my content so interesting. You'll find the Patreon account details in the description box below.